And senior national conference leader Tanveer Sadiq now joins me for more on this. Tanveer Sadiq, if the Indian Army carries out a court of inquiry, then goes through summary of evidence and then comes to the conclusion there is not enough evidence to prosecute five of its officers and men, why would this lead to heartburn? Why is the national conference intending to challenge this?
See, Gaurav, you know, you need to go in the past as well. You know, Patribal, for the rest of the country, maybe just a name. But when it comes in Kashmir, in the valley, it resonates. People here, Patribal issue is a big issue here. I mean, not that it is just an emotional issue, but because, you know, five innocent people have been killed, and which the CBI, one of the premier investigation agency of the country, has proved it that this was a fake encounter. After all these investigations, if after 14 years the army comes out and says that the case is closed, I mean, you're only alienating the people, and the mistrust is becoming bigger and bigger every day. I mean, after 22 years, yes, with the insurgency in the Kashmir Valley, I mean, we should be doing all the things to get people back into the mainstream, rather than just pushing them to the wall. I mean,
that's an important point you're making, this will further alienate people in Jammu and Kashmir. It's an emotive issue, you say, Tanveer Sadiq. What would you have expected of the army? The army says, and I have that statement which you must have read for sure, but for the benefit of our viewers, I'd like to read a section of it. The army says, a comprehensive and exhaustive effort was undertaken to record evidence against all the accused persons. Over 50 witnesses have been examined, including a large number of civilian witnesses, state government and police officers. Forensic and documentary evidence and other relevant evidence was taken on record. And yet, there are no grounds, there is no concrete evidence to proceed against the accused, Tanveer Sadiq.
Do you think there will be any takers for this? I mean, five innocent people have been killed, for heaven's sake. I mean, somebody has to be held accountable for their killings. DNA samples prove that they are innocent. I mean, every investigation that has been done proves that they were innocent people. Now the Supreme Court took a cognizance, and then they asked the army to investigate. They said, we'll do the court-martial then. Now, after so many years, they come out and saying that there is no prima facie evidence. I mean, what about the CBI? The CBI is not a state's agency. It's a central agency. It is one of the most reputed agency. And it itself in its report says that this is a cold-blooded murder. Now, how can you justify something that is not justifiable?
And Omar Abdullah, the chief minister of the state, has tweeted his anguish. What is it that the state government intends to do with this? What kind of intervention is Omar Abdullah talking about, Tanveer Sadiq?
See, like I said, it's really disappointing, you know, at a time when peace is slowly percolating, peace is coming back to the state, when issues like these are raised. Of course, people will again look at certain institutions with suspicion. Now, why Mr. Omar Abdullah, the Honorable Chief Minister of the state, said that we will look at all the options available with us. We have already, the Advocate General and the Law Department is aware of it, and we are looking at all the options, because we can't let our five Kashmiri innocent people being killed, and we can't just let that go just like that. Somebody needs to be held accountable for that.
But the army has turned around and said this was based on specific intelligence. The state police was a part of this operation, and there is the Armed Forces Special Powers Act that protects them, Tanveer Sadiq.
This is precisely what our point has been constantly, that under the garb of AFSPA, you cannot, I mean, these are the issues where this law can be misused. This is precisely the reason we've been asking that, you know, people, such laws which go against people, which can be misused against people, should not be there. And of course, if somebody is saving themselves because of AFSPA, it's not right. I mean, somebody, like I said, somebody has to be held accountable for this.
But now, this could have been an operation, as army sources tell me, Tanveer Sadiq, this could have been in good faith. There was specific intelligence that came. The police was a part of that operation. They launched an operation. According to the army, there was a fierce gunfight that lasted several hours. Five people were killed. It was in good faith that they undertook this operation, thinking that they were killing foreign terrorists. Does that argument hold?
You think? You think, Gaurav, in good faith, you can kill five innocent people and then say that the case is closed as there is no prima facie evidence? What about the CBI report? Why doesn't anybody talk about that? Does that mean that the CBI report was not right? What about the DNA samples? I mean, please, why there are two yardsticks, one in one part and the other in another part? I mean, these are innocent people. Somebody has to stand up and say that, look here, five innocent people have been dead, all the people who have been accused of it. Like the CBI report names all those five army men.
Yes.
I mean, they should be held accountable for that. Nobody can, I see no reason anybody justifying that or saying that, okay, this is in good faith, we did it, so thank you so much. We can't do much about it.
So is this going to be, are you going to proceed on against the army legally? Do you fear street dharna that will take place? Do you see it reverberating across Jammu and Kashmir?
See, first of all, we don't believe in, protest and coming out on the roads. What we believe is in legal options. Like I said, the Advocate General and the Law Department would be looking at it in their own perspective. And legally, whatever we have to do, we'll do it. But we'll not let this go just like that.
Tanveer Sadiq of the National Conference for the moment. Many thanks for joining me. The army, of course, insists it's carried out its inquiry and not found actionable evidence against five officers and men, including a brigadier, a lieutenant colonel, two majors, and a subedar of the 7th Battalion of the Rashtriya Rifles Regiment. We'll be tracking that story.